Welcome back, class. So we were studying about the IV characteristics of the diode, and last time we derived a simpler form of the relationship for the current of the diode, and that was the relationship, right? K VD over T minus 1. So we derived we have seen this simplified relation for the current of the diodes. So in this chapter we are going to see another version of this equations, its derivations, and then we are going to study some more details about the IV characteristics of the diodes. So we have seen this thing last time. Now we are focusing on the determination of the resistance of the forward bias and the reverse bias regions, and the small signal analysis for the operation of the diodes. Okay, so let's see. So we have seen that after the PN junction we get a diode, and this was the anode and cathode, the P type and the N type, and then we learned that how we can actually apply the external battery voltage to break the PN junction, okay, and so that we have the forward bias and the reverse bias saturation, forward bias current and the reverse bias saturation current. And then we have learned about this relationship. So ID is called the diode current or the diffusion current, IS was the saturation current, K was just a constant, okay, eta was the fidelity factor, okay, usually the value of the fidelity factor we take 1. So VD is the diode voltage, okay, forward bias voltage, TK is the room temperature, usually taken as 300K. Okay, and we can calculate the diode currents using this relationship. So we have seen a couple of examples last time. Okay, so now we are actually going to see this alternative presentation or representation of the diode current voltage relationship. So this is another form of the diode current voltage relationship. So this was the relationship which we have seen earlier. Okay, so in this this is the similar one. So ID, the diode current, I naught is the saturation current. Okay, so here we are using IS, so here it's using I naught. Exponential ki power Q VD over NKT. Okay, so or like exponential can be written as in this form. Okay, so the only difference is in the power of the exponential. Okay, so basically if you compare these two equations, so we can found that basically the value of the K which we are getting here is actually equal to Q over NK. Okay, by comparing these two relationships, this value of the K constant is equal to the Q over NK, and then we can get this relationship. So the things are similar here. So Q, we know that the electrical charge value, okay, it's typically 1.6 into 10 to the power 19, a constant. K, here K is called the Boltzmann constant, okay, usually use this number. T is the temperature at room temperature, okay, usually to if you want to convert from centigrade to Kelvin, we use 273, and the room temperature is usually 300 Kelvin, typical value, okay. I naught is the reverse current, saturation current, or simple saturation current with reverse saturation current. N is called the empirical scaling constant, okay, and also we sometimes called it exponential identity factor. So typical value of this is between 0.5 to 2, and usually we take n is equal to 1. Okay, so this is just another representation. Okay, so in this we can derive actually another form of the relationship. So if you guys remember, in the chapter 3 we have derived a relationship for the VT which was equal to K T over Q. Okay, so basically, okay, we can also represent this equation in this form, okay, by just replacing this K T, okay, and bringing this, like just dividing the Q on top and bottom, okay, so we will get the V T here, okay. So this will actually make our equation this equation V D over N V T. This was our original equation, Q VD over NKT, okay, and VT is equal to KT over Q, and for that if you divide with Q on top and bottom, this q will be cancelled and we get kt over q, okay, and we replace this kt over q with this factor vt2. Okay, so this is the like the vt voltage, okay, which we have derived earlier on, okay, and then by putting this we can get this form of the representation. So I naught vt over n into vt, so n is the like the exponential fidelity factor, usually the value is 1. Okay, so this equation can be further simplified to exponential vd over vt. Okay, so if you guys remember, k was the Boltzmann constant, T was the 300 temperature, and the value of the q was 1.69 into 10 to the power minus 19. So if you put all the Boltzmann constant value 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 23, so vt value was 0.026 volt, okay, the typical value, okay, like for the 300 K temperature, okay, for the room temperature condition. So at the room temperature this equation can further simplified to this form, I naught exponential diode forward bias voltage divided by 0.026 minus 1, okay, so we can get a more simplified form of the diode voltage relationship. So if you have just given provided the diode forward bias voltage, okay, for example 0.7 volt, just put that value here and you can calculate the diode forward bias current. Okay, so this is just like the derivations of the another form of the representation of the diode currents. Okay, so we can actually either use this one or this one, okay, and they are interrelated. Now if the we know that if you just multiply inside, okay, so we will get I naught exponential, okay, vd over nvt, okay, because this can be replaced, minus I naught. Okay, so this is the reverse bias saturation current. Okay, so if the and this part is actually the forward bias. Okay, so if the forward bias current, we usually have seen last time also, the forward bias current is much greater than the reverse bias current. Okay, so if the forward bias current is very large, okay, so then we can actually approximate this relationship to only this value, that id is approximately equal to I naught e vd over nvt. The forward bias current is much larger than, because this will become approximately equal to zero or very small value. Okay, so this is just a relationship. Okay, now let's see about the, so this is that simplified relationship which we have just derived here, that the diode current, if the forward bias current is much larger, we can just represent using this relationship, I naught times e vt over n vt. Okay, so this is the forward bias region of the diode. Okay, so in the forward bias the current can be approximated with only forward bias current only, and this is actually the reverse bias, but okay, the usually we say that this is the whole curve current. Okay, and we have the VD or VF voltage, the diode voltage. After that the p-n junction is the diode become forward bias and the current start flowing. Okay, so now if you focus here, so this is the voltage, this is the current. If I just calculate the slope of this curve, okay, so we can calculate the slope by just taking two points, right? Okay, so this first point is like the x value is v d and the corresponding y value, let's say, is id dash. Similarly we can get another point here, that will be vd, like let's say this is vd dash and id dash, this is vd double dash and id dash, any two numbers. If you just calculate the slope, so slope is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, right? So that is actually called the slope. So basically slope, if you just calculate, and finally we can represent slope in the form of the ratio of the voltage and current. okay, x2 minus x1 over y2 minus y1 is the slope, okay. So the slope of this line can be represented in the form of vd over id, okay. So v over I is basically the resistance, right? So remember Ohm law, V is equal to IR and R is equal to V over I, okay? So basically the slope of the forward bias line, the forward bias current characteristics, it represents the resistance of the diode, okay? Or we call this as forward bias resistance of the diode. Okay, or this is also called as the DC resistance of the diode. Okay, DC resistance of diode. So by just taking the slope of the forward bias line, can calculate the diode. Okay, now this is important thing here. Okay, so basically in the forward bias region, okay, so once like the junction is like broken for the flow of the current, okay, so at that time, okay, usually we have seen that the forward bias current is much high, right? So if the forward bias current is much high, okay, so this resistance is VD over ID, okay. So if this current value is high, it means the current value is high, these are inversely proportional, so the resistance will be low, okay. So usually the forward bias resistance, okay, its value is lower, okay. And in the reverse bias, usually we have seen that the value of the current is very low, okay? So if the value of the current is low, then the value of the resistance will be very high. So the forward bias resistance is usually low, and the reverse bias resistance is usually high, okay? So which we can actually derive from these two equations. Again, this is the characteristics which I have seen earlier. The this graph shows the relationship between the germanium and silicon. So we are getting different curves, okay, IV characteristics for the silicon and germanium. So I will ask you that why we are actually getting the different curves, okay. So this is my question for you. So we will discuss, and I will ask you that why we are getting different curves in the live session. So you have to study this and determine that why we are getting the different curves, okay. So the diode DC resistance, as I said earlier, we can calculate, okay, RD over VD over ID. If the forward bias, it's called forward bias resistance, so we'll take in the forward bias voltage over forward bias current. If reverse bias, we call this reverse bias resistance, so we'll take in the reverse bias voltage divided by the reverse bias current, okay. So by using just these formulas, we can calculate the DC resistance or static resistance of the diode. See the example which we will solve. You can practice, but we will solve this in the live session. The second part of this lecture is actually a very important topic. It's called the small signal analysis of the diode. Okay. So the purpose of small signal analysis is, okay, we want to determine the AC resistance of the diode. AC resistance, or like if your input is AC, okay, then how the diode will be operating, okay, what will be the response of the diode for the AC input, okay. So small signal is we called AC. So usually, generally we apply the DC voltage here, so this is the DC supply, okay. And now if you want to calculate this current ID, so this current will be equal to this voltage supply minus the voltage drop here, okay, and divided by this resistance value, right? So that will be actually the current, if you want to calculate the current, okay. So we can calculate by using this relationship, okay, divided by R, okay. Or if I just like the KVL, the total voltage drop here, V is equal to voltage drop here plus ID into R. If I want to find diode voltage, it will be equal to V minus ID into RL. Okay, so these are just the representation. Okay, now let's do two things here. Okay, let's consider that. Okay, so let me me write just the main equation here. V is equal to Vd plus Id into RL. Okay. So let's say if the diode current is zero, if diode current is zero, then voltage will be equal to Vd, right? So I want to plot. So this is my voltage variable and this is my Id variable. Okay. So if diode current is zero, diode current is zero means I am here. Okay. So at that time my voltage will be equal to Vd. Vd voltage will be actual V volt. So I will get this one point. Okay. Now let's say if the value of Vd is zero. Vd is zero means I will be on this line. If Vd is 0, it means then my current, I will get V is equal to Id into RL, or Id will be equal to V over RL. So I will get this point. So if I just join these two points, okay, this is called load line. Okay, and this is the diode characteristics, a typical curve, okay, which slope is just given by 1 over RL, okay. So, and this will be this point, which is the intersection point, is called Q point or operating point of the diode. Okay, this is called Q point or operating point of the diode. Okay, so whenever we are using AC signals, we try to use operate the diode around the operating point. Okay, so if you operate around the operating points, okay, then the losses will be like the clipping or the we will get a good response, like according to the applied input AC signal. Okay. So then this is an example of the AC small signal analysis, which we will solve during the live session, inshallah. Okay. We will see during the live session that how the actual response of the look like. Okay. So we will get actually different Q points here. Okay. And this will be our input, and this is our output. So we will see that how we are actually getting these different points. Okay, so basically then based on like we are having the change in the voltage value here and we are having the change in the current value here. So if we check this, the ratio of this small voltage change with the small current change, okay, so we can calculate the dynamic resistance of the diode, or sometimes it is called as the AC resistance of the diode. So basically by checking, taking the ratio of the small voltage change with the small current change, okay, we can calculate the dynamic resistance or the AC resistance. Okay, remember the DC resistance for RD is equal to the forward bias voltage Vd over Id. Okay, Vf over If for forward bias and the reverse bias. But if you want to calculate the AC or dynamic resistance, we have to take the small change in voltage over the small change in the current. Okay, so this is called AC or dynamic resistance of the diode. So we can actually derive this the relationship, okay, the more detailed form of the relationship, by just taking the if you remember our original equation was, which we have just derived earlier, Id is equal to I naught exponential Vd over nVd. Okay, so if we just take the derivative of this one, okay, with respect to Vd, like we take derivative of Id with respect to Vd, okay, then we can actually get this relationship. Okay, if we just like simplify the diode here, okay, and further if we do some more simplification, finally we can actually derive this relationship. Okay, so I will briefly explain this in the live session, this explanation that how we can actually get. So the finally the one form of the diode, this is the generalized conceptual equation, that the change of the voltage, our change of current, is the dynamic resistance. Okay, this is the actual typical formula. Okay, n Vd over Vd. Okay, the typical value of the n is 1. Vd value, we know that usually we take 26 millivolt or 0.026 volt and divided by the Id. So whatever Id value we are having, okay, we can calculate the AC or dynamic resistance. So the total resistance of the diode is usually the DC resistance plus this dynamic resistance or AC resistance. Okay, so that is actually typical total resistance of the diode. So that is actually the end of this lecture. Okay, so we will see some detailed derivations wherever it is necessary, and examples in the live session. Thank you very much for your time.